All right, so let me just walk you through the syllabus. So this is a syllabus for Dynamic 365 CRM developer training. So let me just show you the course structure. Yeah, this is the first module where we talk about the Dynamic 365 CRM functionality. What is CRM? What is XRM platform, etc. We'll talk in detail about the sales and service module, a little bit on the marketing module as well. Sales and service is more important. Then we'll talk about the configuration part. There we'll see how to create the security role, how to create the users, how to do the basic configuration for the users, etc. We'll also talk about system setting. So the second module is more like all the configuration and administration tasks that the developers as well as functional consultant need. So even being a developer or a functional consultant, you also need to know how to configure the application, how to deal with the security roles, how the security structure is built in. All that detail. So you are not going to the installation of Dynamics 365 CRM or all the migration, etc. But we are talking about the configuration and basic administration. So where we talk about business management settings, data management setting, product catalog, how to configure the product catalog, how to set up the pricing list, etc. And also deal with data management, how to upload bulk data into CRM system, or how to set up duplicate detection rules. Then how to configure data maps and how to import data into CRM system. So when you have a lot of data with us, you have to import that into CRM system. Then, like I mentioned, the product catalog, we'll see how to add the product to the catalog, how to create the price list, and how to utilize this price list in your opportunity, quotes, and orders. Then comes the third module, which is a lengthier module. It takes around 12 hours to complete. Here we talk about how CRM system is structured, what is the MSCRM entity model, and how we can customize it. So we will see form customization, how to customize the form, how to customize the entities, how to customize the attributes of the entities. Then we'll talk about relationship, that is nothing but the relationship among the tables, how it is structured, what are the different types of relationship we have, how we can configure that. And also we talk about a concept known as entity mapping, that is like mapping fields from the parent entity to the child entity. Then we talk about views. Views are nothing but the saved queries in CRM system. We will see what are the different types of views we have, how to customize them, etc. Then comes the fourth module. So here we talk about customizing CRM system beyond UI. So many of the things we can do or we can do customize with the help of UI itself. So but whenever the complex requirement comes, we cannot perform that. In such situation, we will use code and then we customize system. So there are many different ways to do that. One is like using JavaScript to customize on the CRM form. We can implement validation, etc. on the CRM form. And the second one is using writing code, server-side code, like writing plugin. So these are the different ways to extend it. So we will see what are the different ways of customization possible. What is supported and unsupported customization? Some of the customization that you do is not supported. That means it's not recommended. It will work for you, but it's not recommended. It makes some issues when you perform upgrade, etc. So supported customizations are there and unsupported customizations are there when you perform customization using code. So, and then plugins are there. Plugins are one of the most important sessions of this training. And as a developer, you will be developing plugin most of the time. So we use either C#.NET or VB.NET to develop plugin. So plugins are nothing but extension to your existing CRM functionality. So CRM have a lot of functionality, as you know. We can extend this functionality by writing code. That is what plugins are. It's a very strong feature of Dynamics CRM or Dynamics 365. Then comes the customer flow activities. In CRM, we have workflows. Workflows are nothing but processes that you can create with the help of UI. You can create workflows, and then workflows will trigger whenever any condition is met. So workflows are nothing but event handlers. Even plugins are event handlers. So we can create workflows with the help of UI, but it has certain limitations. So writing code, we can customize even the customer workflow activities and dialogues. So we'll talk about that. So it's a very strong feature again. We can take the UI comments, then we can write code and we can customize it. So that's it's very powerful. We'll also look into how to customize Dynamics CRM ribbons. In CRM system, we have two areas at the top. At the top one is known as the ribbon, and the second one is known as sitemap. So both these areas we will customize. These are UI comments. So we can customize them with the help of tools as well as manual ways we can do it. Also, finally, we will touch upon creating report for CRM system. So in CRM, we can create report in different ways. One is using a tool with the name report wizard. That is a UI comment. Using that, we can do. And then we can also create report with the help of SSRS. SQL Server reporting services. So when you use SSRS to create a report, you'll use that with the help of Visual Studio outside of CRM system. So we can use two types of queries inside that, either fetch XML query or SQL query. So these are the two types of report you can create. And this report, once you create, will make RDL files out of it, and then you upload to CRM system. So this is what we are going to see. I believe you guys have some idea about what is CRM. Anyway, I'll just tell you what is CRM from a definition standpoint. So CRM refers to the practices, strategies, and technologies that companies use to manage and analyze their customer interaction. So whenever a company or an organization interact with their customers, that will happen majorly in three areas or in three ways. One is marketing, second one is sales, and third one is customer service. So CRM is all about that. So these are the major three areas where you interact with your customers. The other one would be like field service. That is also a part of your customer service. So you know what will happen in the marketing. So if a company is going to launch a new product, let's take an example of a car. They are manufacturing a new car. So even before the car is going to launch in the market, 3 months or 6 months prior to that, they'll start advertising about it. They'll start taking the pre-booking for that. So they will sit together and they will put up a strategy saying that, okay, this car is going to sell for this price, so we have to start marketing for this from this month, etc. We will make a plan for that. So all the marketing they will plan it. So they need a system to just plan all this. And after that, they'll execute these plans. So it will be an email campaign. It will be a roadshow. It could be something like they are conducting some test drive shows or whatever it is. So people who are interested to buy a new car or they're trying to change a new car, they will come to their store. They start getting inquiries over phone, email, etc. So these are nothing but the leads, the inquiries. So that is the intention of marketing people. Just broadcast the message of their brand and product. And whenever inquiries comes, they collect all these inquiries, filter out it. So that is what the duty of the marketing people, just collect inquiries from the interested people. Then they will hand over these inquiries to the salespeople. The salespeople get all this, depends upon the location, they will segregate that. Then they will just start calling these customers and then ask them for appointment. If it is a car, they will ask them to come to the showroom, or they will just go to the client location and then give them test drive. And if client is okay, after test drive, they will just understand the customer budget, their requirement. Then they will propose them, okay, this car or this product is better for you as per your budget. They will also help them to get the finance. And finally, the sales happen. So the sales is also done. When the sales is done, then the customer will have a lot of issues, as you know. So they will come to the show, or they will just call the help desk, or whichever it is possible, they will get a service. So when they are coming for service, they will call up the help desk. For the very first time when they call, then they need to register their details. And next time onwards, their details will be there. So even if you just give your customer number or name, the customer support agent will search for your name and then tell them, okay, this is your first service. Because they will see the detail. And if has been servicing the car for like last 1 or 2 years, then all his service history will be there. So this is a system. CRM is a system where the business can keep track of all their marketing, sales, and customer service data. So if a client is implemented CRM to interact with the customer, their client interaction will be better. We know we have a lot of experience for that. So if you call to any of your mobile service providers, every time you have to tell the same story to them, because they don't have a proper CRM in place. If they had, every time we call them, they will be able to pull up the information about the issues that we raise. So we'll feel important or we feel valued, because we don't want to explain it again and again. That's why customer service is very frustrating for us, because they don't keep track of our issues properly. And even the same way in sales also. If I just went to a showroom and then I inquire about a car, I might spend 1 or 2 hours there. Then if I go to one of their other showroom, or if I call another guy and he is asking me the same inquiry again, same questions again, I will get frustrated, because I already spent a few hours explaining them my requirement, understand everything. Then if some guy has to follow up with that, he shouldn't ask me the same question. But that is possible if they have a proper CRM system where all their sales information, customer requirement, everything is mentioned. So CRM is all about improving an organization's relationship with its customers so that they can improve their sales and also they can retain their customers. So many of the customers leave the present service provider because they are not getting the service proper. And if we have a proper CRM system in place, we can keep track of the customer data and we can serve the customer better. So that is about CRM. So we can perform CRM activities without having an online system also. That's what people used to do earlier days. They used to perform all this detail in Excel sheet, even before internet came into picture. They used to perform all this spreadsheet, all the leads information they will mention in one sheet, all the client information they will mention in another sheet. So they can just refer that. Even small business do that these days. So even before computers came into picture, people used to do is using paper and files. They used to keep track of all this. But somehow you have to keep all your customer data. Now we have internet, now we have many CRM systems in place. You can perform automation, you can do it. So that is about CRM. So these are the major CRM systems in place: Salesforce CRM, Dynamics CRM, SAP, Oracle, Zoho. That's an Indian product. And then we have a couple of open source CRM as well. So Salesforce CRM and Dynamics CRM are the market leaders. So I might be using the word Dynamics CRM or Dynamics 365. So Dynamics 365 is more than a CRM. It includes both CRM as well as ERP functionalities. We'll talk about that in some time. But whenever I use the word Dynamics CRM or Dynamics 365, I refer to the same thing. So these are the common features of a CRM. We have Salesforce automation, marketing management, and service center automation. So like I mentioned, we have sales, service, and a marketing operation. So the sales teams of your organization, Salesforce means sales team of your organization, this can automate their operation. So I can give an example. If there are inquiries coming in your website, and then if you have an employee who is taking all these inquiries one by one, then just email the salespeople based on their location. So this person who is receiving this inquiry has to go through each and every mail. Sometimes they will not have proper details even there. Then they have to call up that sales guy or then assign them. So it is a tedious job if you have 100 or 150 inquiries coming in a day. But we can perform a lot of automation on that, with CRM also. What we can do is on the website, we can have a contact us form where you can just mention the location of the inquiry also. And once after this inquiry is submitted, then we can link that to a CRM system. It's very easy to do. So that on click of the submit button, the information will be pushed to CRM system. And then we can set up some workflows. This workflows will check the location of this particular lead or inquiry, and then we can assign to the salesperson based on their location. So even if 150 or 100 or 1000 inquiries coming in a day, it will be all assigned to salespeople based on the location automatically. So you don't need a person for that. Otherwise, if you want to handle 150 inquiries a day, I mean, not one person, it is more than one person is needed. Right? So Salesforce automation, second one is marketing management. So marketing people can perform all their marketing activities using CRM system. They can perform everything from planning their marketing campaign, in which location they have to do it, marketing budget, and also they can even calculate ROI, return on investment. So marketing people are concerned about that. And third one is service center automation. Like I mentioned, we can also perform a lot of automation and scheduling on the service side. So whenever customers calls you for any service, if we have automation properly done, then we can just assign it to the proper people. If we have some, for example, in a customer support scenario, in a BPO environment, if we have 100 BPO agent or customer support agent, and if they have calls coming in, and then if you want to assign that, we can do that. Similar way I explained for Salesforce automation. We can implement automation for service center, and also we can perform scheduling. I need to schedule a ticket for a particular field agent who is going to a customer location and perform the repairing operation. And if you have multiple field agents or engineers who are located in different offices, so as a customer support agent, I can schedule it. So who is the field engineer who is near to the customer location? I can schedule a job for him or her, so they can just go to the client location and perform the operation. So all this can be do, and also we can perform social engagement. What I mean by that is these days we have social media platform. So where we can just interact with the customers. We can use social media for many things. First thing is we can perform marketing on that. We can conduct marketing campaign, publish to the audience. And whenever there is inquiries coming up, we can take it. So I do this, I do business. So we also market over social media. We'll do on LinkedIn, Facebook, YouTube. You guys might, some of you might came through Facebook, some of you might came through YouTube. So these are all the channels we have. So if you use a tool with the name Microsoft Social Engagement or MSC, which can be integrated with the Dynamics 365, so that we can perform marketing campaign on social media, and also we can take contacts or details from social media. So it is as simple as creating a lead from an inquiry on Facebook. If someone is posting a comment on your page, and then as a social media marketer, you can just convert that and that comment into a lead. Or somebody is talking about an issue of your product, and you can convert that post or tweet into a CRM ticket. That's what we can do. So this is how dynamic this CRM application look like. I cannot call it purely CRM because it is more than a CRM application. So here we have the apps. I'll walk you through this again. So here we have sales, customer service, and field service. And marketing comes under sales. So here we have the modules like sales. We have accounts, contact, leads, opportunity. I'll walk you through all of this. I'll explain this. So we have sales, marketing, and service. Also, we have field service, which is an extended version of customer support. Field engineers go to client location, then they will perform the operation. And project service also there. So these are, they call it as apps these days. Earlier they used to call it as modules, then now we call it as apps. So in addition to it, you can also create your own apps. So if you're coming from a Salesforce background, Salesforce CRM background, you'll appreciate it. When in Salesforce, this feature is there for a long time because you can create your own app. So what you are seeing here is all apps. So if I just go to customer service, the modules I will be seeing here will be different. So you can just secure your application. So earlier we had only one app that you can customize, but now it is not like that. Within the same Dynamic CRM account, you can create multiple apps. If you need one app for sales, that is possible. One for marketing, that is possible. Or if you need to make one customized app for some features from sales and marketing, that is also possible. So we have many things over to explain. So now I am on the service app. So what you will see would be different now. So if you are working on a production environment, or if you are just working as a sales guy for an organization where they use Dynamics 365, so you'll not be able to see the service module at all, because it is, you don't have permission to access it. You'll have permission only to go to the sales module, and then you can access the sales related entities. You won't be able to perform operation on customer service. But now, when you log into an account here for the development purpose, you'll be able to access all the modules. But business people will be able to see only one module at a time. So now I am the sales module. Then you can see sales and marketing. I cannot see customer service. What you're seeing here is like this one and the Magnifez CRM. These are nothing but customized apps. So where we have only two entities. So you can create customized app, customized module, then you can just give access. So we can perform a lot of operations. We'll explain each of that. Then we have the dashboards over here, etc. We'll come back here. So what are the common elements of a CRM system? This is generic, not on Dynamics 365. This is generic. We'll have sales module, marketing module, service. Then we have contact management. So whenever you're dealing with your customers, you'll have a lot of contacts. The mechanic working that workshop, the salesperson of that company, the CEO of this organization. So many contacts you'll be dealing with. When you're performing the marketing activity, you'll get a lot of inquiries. Then you'll convert these inquiries into business. Then once the business is done, then they will become customers and they will come for your issues. So for marketing people, it's all about inquiries. For sales people, it's all about business. And for customer service people, it's all about issues. That's how it is. So we can keep track of the contact. Then we have something known as workflows, or we call it as processes. So if you're working AS400, I don't know how that one. You are from different background. So there are workflow concept is there in many places. Even in SharePoint, we have this concept. Even in marketing automation tools, we have this concept. So we can automate a lot of operations. So workflows are basically processes using which we can automate your business processes. Business process means, like I mentioned, whenever an inquiry is coming, assign it to some people. Or whenever someone is putting a resignation, so its resignation has to be approved within 15 days by the manager. So that is a company policy. If he is not approving within 15 days, it will send an escalation mail to the supervisor or the HR manager. So that is a company business process. So that you can implement with the help of a workflow. Then you have reporting. So your company executive needs a lot of reports. We can implement that. Then collaboration. Your employees need to collaborate with one another so we can perform. So these are the common features of a CRM system. So what are the benefits of implementing a CRM system? I'm not going in depth to that. It will improve the efficiency of your workforce. It will improve collaboration among your workforce and employees, sales and marketing people can collaborate each other. You can manage your data. Once data is stored in your CRM system, you can convert that from one form to another, but data will be there. For example, an inquiry comes, you convert that into a customer. Later, you will convert that into an issue. So like that, we can keep track of the data. Improve customer experience, that is the point. So getting a customer is difficult, but retaining them is easier. But to retain the customer, you need to have information or the history about that customer. So CRM will help you to do that. Now, how CRM can help your business? We talk about that, what are the features in the last slide. And this slide will say how a CRM can help your business. This is somewhat related to what we explained in the previous slide. Improve your customer data. So a business strength is on the data of your customer. I'm facing that issue now. So we have a lot of inquiries, you have a lot of students, you have a lot of consulting provided. Now, if you get all this detail properly in a one place or in multiple tabs, then it will be very easy for us just to push them offers, just to interact with them, and if they have any issues, to solve them. But if your data is in multiple places, like YouTube, we have some data, and then we have multiple Excel sheet in different places. So if you are going to performing a marketing campaign for these people, it will be too tough because the data will be in multiple sheet in multiple places and different people are handling it. So it is a headache. But if you have a CRM system in place, then all the data will be in one place. So that will improve your efficiency. You can manage sales team activity. The sales manager can see, okay, how many sales guys you have and how many sales people are from Bangalore and how they are doing, how many deals they are closing each week and how much revenue they have made. So all this we can see from the report as well as the dashboard. And the management can take informed decisions. That means if I'm seeing how many sales are happening, how many inquiries are being converted into customers every week. And I can look at in which area it is lagging, in which area it is happening. So if I see that one salesperson is not working properly or he's not able to convert the leads properly, by looking at the system, I can see that. So I can just replace him with another sales guy, or I can just give him some training, or I can send him to some other manager. So I can take all the decision by looking at the system. I don't need to ask anyone. And finally, manage your revenue. So like I mentioned, I can see all the revenue of my customers in one single place. Then I can manage it where revenue is lagging, where revenue is happening. I can take necessary actions for that. Now let's talk about dynamic 365 CRM. So we have to talk about dynamic 365 also. We will talk about that in a slide, few slides after this. So dynamic CRM or dynamic 365 CRM is the customer relationship management solution from Microsoft. This is the only CRM solution that Microsoft has. They don't have any other. It is part of Microsoft Dynamics family of applications. Microsoft got a suite of Dynamics applications. So they got 5 ERP applications, 1 CRM application. We'll talk about that. So ERP application includes Dynamics AX, Dynamics Navision, Dynamics GP, etc. And then one Dynamics CRM application. It's very easy to use. It can be accessed from online, tablets, mobile devices. It is developed based on .NET framework. So you can extend it using C# .NET as well as JavaScript. A little bit on the history of CRM. So there was an application with the name iCommunicate.NET that is known as a predecessor of Microsoft CRM. It was not developed by Microsoft. Microsoft acquired that company and then they released a very fast version of CRM, CRM 1.0 in January 2003. Then comes CRM 1.2. 3.0, 4.0, and then CRM 2011 in February 2011. So this was a major release of Microsoft CRM, and they added a lot of features in this release, and then they become popular. So since then, it is very hot in the market. Then they came out with CRM 2013, 2015, 2016, and in November 2016, they released a new version of CRM system that is known as Dynamic 365. So if we talk about the CRM version of Dynamics 365, that is known as Dynamics CRM version 8.2. And CRM 2016 is version 8. And there is one more version is released, that is Dynamics 365 version 9.0. You might have read about it online. That is Dynamics CRM version 9. So we are in version 9 now. So here we have version 4, version 5, version 6, version 7, version 8. And then Dynamics 365 is version 9. And this is Dynamics Stack or Dynamics family of application. We have one CRM application and 5 ERP application available. Dynamics AX, Dynamics GP, Dynamics Navision. Solomon, and C5. So why I'm talking about all this is, now we have Dynamics 365, which includes the modules from Dynamics CRM, Dynamics AX, and Navision. So they have taken some modules from AX, some modules from Navision. So in future, you'll not have this because the stack is going to be completely into Dynamics AX, but at, sorry, Dynamics 365. At the moment, we have Dynamics AX is there, Dynamics Navision is there, Dynamics CRM is there separately, but future, they will move completely out of the stack. So we can access CRM from web browsers, any web browser. We can access from mobile devices. We have smartphone apps for Android, iOS, and Windows phones. Also, we can access from Outlook. Outlook also we can access here. We have to configure that. Once we configure, we can access from Outlook as well. Deployment model, we are talking about that just a little earlier. We are just talking about the CRM in general. So we can deploy your CRM system on-premise. That means if you have a Zoho, you can install it and we can configure it. We can give access to your users. CRM online, so this is managed by Microsoft. You can just reach out to Microsoft, then you can access. That's what we are going to do. We are going to create a CRM online account. Partner hosted, so if you want to access your server, if you want to access the CRM system, then you can go to the hybrid model. So partner hosted is kind of a hybrid model. You can just reach out to one of Microsoft partner. They will implement it for you. They'll install it for you. Then we can just pay them. But it will be server. You can manage the server, but it will be also managed by your partner. They will do the operation for you. So these are the three options we have. So the training will be given based on CRM online. Functionality wise, all the three are same. We'll give the training on CRM online. So I'll walk you through how to create a trial account, so where you can practice.